Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm going to do a classic rock reaction, man. This is Steely Dan. Steely Dan, the Gaucho album, the seventh studio album from Steely Dan. And what I'm going to do here is, this is going to be my last reaction to the Steely Dan chronology for a while. I'm going to leave it and then come back to it a little bit later and then complete it. I'm a big fan of Steely Dan after the first six albums. I'm told that if I do have to take that break with Steely Dan, I definitely have to complete this one. So Steely Dan, of course, overlapped into December. And you know what? I'm just going to sometimes overlap when I feel I have to. If I am not satisfied with how far I've come along with the Almonds, for example, I'm going to overlap into January, and that's that. So, I'm talking like this because yesterday my intention was to do the whole Gaucho album, and then to do the whole Eat a Peach album, and then to do a complimentary quad. So it was basically you, me, and the day, and then John comes over. Terry's driving by. He's like, "Oh, Wayne's home. John's there. I'll stop in." And then Paul stops in. And then family comes by. And before I knew it, man, I had 25 people in my damn house. You know, not even stop. Don't you hate when people just drop in on your ass? Yo, and your entire day is just thrown out. So I was entertaining and I was doing this and I was doing that. My whole damn day gone. So this is what I did. I parked behind the back. So, today, man, it's just you, me, and the Almonds, and Steely Dan. So, Steely Dan, Gaucho, side one. I've been looking forward to this, man. I heard great things. If I can get myself untangled. Here we go. Gaucho, side one. Let's get it. The brass has a really good place in. Turn that jungle music down just until we're out of town. This is no one night stand, it's a real occasion. Close your eyes and you'll be there. It's everything they say. The end of a perfect day, distant lights from across the bay. Babylon sister, shake it. Babylon sister, shake it. So fine, so young. Tell me I'm the only one. Spot.
blossom from a shell. San Francisco, show and tell. Well, I should know by now that it's just a spasm, like a Sunday in TJ, that it's cheap but it's not free, that I'm not what I used to be, and that love's not a game for three.
Babylon.
Sex. They're singing about the, I guess, the club life of California. Fast life, fast women. I really dig the presence of the brass in this number. Good song. Good story being told. You can just totally get the images of California and the lifestyle.
Way back when
I know this tune.
Thank you.
The musicianship in here is just so nice, man. Perfect. You talk about a song being a masterpiece. It's this one. Fantastic song. Haven't heard it in a long time. I bet this is among your favorites where Steely Dan is concerned. This song is about a the glamorous life of a drug dealer. These guys are great storytellers. Thank you. doesn't that sound like a full orchestra? They really employ all of their instruments so well. Everything has its place, seems so well fitted. Man, their musicianship is on point. All right, then. So that is side one. Gaucho. They got it all going for them, man, these guys. Great musicianship, harmony. Great individual musicians coming together in a session format and creating something really, really masterful. At the helm, of course, is Becker and Fagan leading the way. They really, really have this jazz rock platform just fine-tuned. And of course, you know, the standout song on this side one is for sure Hey 19. But I like them all. They all tell a great story. And that's the thing about Steely Dan that is first and foremost in my mind, seven albums later. They are now officially, and you can quote me, they are my favorite storytelling rock band. When you're talking about taking you on a trip, telling a story, all of that sort of thing, these guys are without a doubt, there's nobody else even close to them. They are my favorite rock storytellers. And I'm going to continue with their chronology, of course. A little bit spread out, not so much back to back, but yeah, I'm not gonna stop until I finished a lot of their studio work, and then I'll probably venture into some of their live takes. I don't know what they look or sound like live, but it's something that I definitely want to check out. If you happen to know some really decent live takes of Steely Dan, send them my way and I'll make time to do a reaction to that, because I don't recall in the last seven albums ever doing any kind of live take reaction. So, man, maybe I'm wrong. I don't recall, though. But, yeah, man, overall, that's the biggest takeaway. Seven albums later, about Steely Dan. They are officially my favorite storytellers in rock. That's the accolade that I'm giving them, man. Fantastic. And you listen to these songs, and I'm sure that a couple of more listens, you'll pick up more and you'll get the gist of things. There's many references that I've missed along the way that it will kind of connect with a few more listens. Get the lyrics in front of me and just kind of do a little research, and it'll all fit a little bit better. But overall, I get the big gist of what they're doing, how they're using the jazz rock platform, and they are master storytellers, man. That would be on their tombstone. If I was to say, let's put Steely Dan to rest, what are we going to put on that tombstone? The most masterful of rock storytellers to date. You know, I still got a long way to go. Yes, I got to uncover. Yes, Yes, I've got to do more Pink Floyd. Yes, I've got to do a lot more. But up till now, 1 year and a bit later of launching this channel, these guys are without a doubt, in my mind, the best rock storytellers. Yes, even better than Rush, in my opinion. So don't slay me, it's just my opinion. Anyway, hey man, this is side one. I'm going to cut this off and I'll hit side two either later when I get home, if there's enough time. I got to go into work for a little bit, or first thing in the morning. But definitely, I want to get side two and the review attached to side two done, and then that'll be it for Steely Dan for a while. In the meantime, I'm going to also get on to Eat a Peach as soon as I can, and try and get at least side one done. I don't know if time will allow for me to hit up a complimentary quad today, but I'll see how it goes. I'll see how long I can stay hidden from friends and family just dropping in on me. Anyways, man, you guys have yourselves a good day, and I'll catch you in side two and a review. Peace.